What is a Perron? Welcome back to our channel Inside Python, and welcome back to the third episode of our Kiwi development series. So now in this video, we're going to be learning how to use the Kiwi design language for more simplicity of code and etc. etc. So now Kiwi design language is much more similar to CSS. If you know HTML, CSS, it is a bit of help, but it is very easy to learn, and it is just very easy to learn. So we don't need to do actual coding in order to create GUIs. I will show you that. It is very interesting. So now first of all, we need to create the Kiwi file. So what would be the name of the file? First of all, let's discuss that. So suppose my app class is my app. So the name of the Kiwi file should be my.kiwi, my in lower cases. So you remember the pattern here. Suppose if I write my grid app, so the name will be mygrid.kiwi. So just remove the app and turn all the things in lower cases, and just put a .kv in the last, and that you got your name. So ready my app. Okay, so no, it was not like this. Okay. Now create a file. Now since I'm on my PyCharm, so I can directly create files. So write here my.kv. Okay. So now in this, what we need to do, so I've already, this is the code from the last video. I've deleted some part of it. So we have a grid layout class, this mygrid, which has a function login. So we will use this class. As we are returning this class, so we have to do something in this class. Okay, so right here, mygrid. Okay, simple, mygrid. Just put a colon there and come in the back line, press the tab. Just as easy as that. Now what we need to do is, so in the last video we created a GUI that accepts username, the password, and displays a button as login, and does something with a login function. So now what we're going to do, write here grid layout. So if you have watched the last video, so you remember that we used two grid layouts, one the inner one, all the labels and text inputs was in the inner one, and the button was in the outer grid layout, so as to, you know, put the button in the center. So in this, specify calls as one. Okay, now create second grid layout. So this is the outermost grid layout. It will just have column one. Okay, so write a grid layout, and this will have columns, two columns it will have for the label and the text input. So write here label, which will have, so as you can see, it is like really helpful. So write here text, and the text would be what? The text would be username. Okay, you wrote that. Now come here, write here text input, and write here multi lines. Okay, multi lines false. Okay, just easy as that. Now we did this for username. Just copy this code, or let me just show you this much amount of code only. So just run it. Okay, none type object is not subscriptable. So I think I ran into an error, or guess, I don't know. So 16 in mode. So let me just finish that full, and then we will discuss about it. So the grid layout columns, the label, the text input, the multi lines, and just copy this for the password also. So I've copied this, just paste it and write your password. Okay, so password, and just put a colon here. Okay, put here. So now one thing to notice here, we are not using any kind of programming to create GUIs. We are just writing, it's like CSS, and we're using colons in case of assignment operators and etc. etc. Now we will define the button. So come to the outer grid layout and write here, okay, button, and write here text. What the text will be writing? Login. It's as easy as that. Now let's try to run it. I don't want any errors, guys. Okay, so none type object is not callable. I don't even know these files. What are these? Load kv file name, self.kv file, and my. Okay, so I guess I figured out the problem. The problem was through the indentation. I did the indentation wrong. So I've just changed it. So let's try to run it again. Control shift F10. 10, and you can see WordUS being displayed here again. Now, why is it in the right? Because whenever you create the my.kv file, we haven't set any kind of dimensions here. Okay, so how to do that? Now, in this grid layout, right here, size. Okay, so this doesn't work. The Z key doesn't work in my keyboard, so I have to write it like size as root.width. Now root specifies the current instance of the full program of our app. So let's try to run it again. Control Shift F10. So just with one just bit of a line change, we created this function. Now it is very easy, you know, we haven't done any kind of coding and we just created the GUI. So it's very easy. Now, so I think I will be winding up here. Now in the next video, I'm going to be showing you how to take the inputs from the text input and save it in a variable and how to bind a function to button in the KV file. So yeah, if you like my video, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe for more of such videos, and thanks for watching our video.